Hello, and welcome to the second video in our course on scientific writing. In the previous video, we learned about various story structures. In this video, we'll explore in more depth one of these story structures called OCAR. Recall from last time that OCAR stood for opening, challenge, action, and resolution. When thinking about how to structure an OCAR story, it's useful to visualize this funnel that has an opening at the top and the bottom. Just like this funnel, you want your story to start off with a broad opening, then narrow down to the challenge. The action will also be somewhat narrow, but then the resolution should be wide, so you can relate it to the discussion in the opening. It's also useful to introduce another element here, called the funnel. The funnel is really part of the opening, but as we'll see later, it's useful to think of it as its own story element. Okay, let's start with the opening. To do so, we'd like to answer some specific questions, like, what is the larger problem you're addressing? And why are you addressing this problem? In the funnel, we want to give the reader some background. So in this section, we're going to answer the question, what do you need to understand about the situation to follow the story? In the challenge, we answer the following questions. What specific questions do you propose to answer? And what needs to be accomplished to do so? In the action, you're going to tell the reader about the work that you did. Specifically, you want to answer the question, what happens to address the challenge? And finally, in the resolution, you want to tell the reader what you learned. So you'll answer the question, how has the larger problem from the opening changed as a result of your work? Writing down the answers to these questions is a really great way to start the writing process. For starters, having such questions as prompts is a good way to overcome writer's block, because you're not just staring at a blank screen or a blank piece of paper waiting for inspiration to strike. But as we'll see in upcoming videos, you can also take those answers that you've written down, and with some slight tweaking, you'll be well on your way to having a pretty good first draft of your paper or thesis. Now, in the remainder of this video, I'm going to walk you through an example of how I would answer these questions for the project I mentioned in the example from the previous video. After that, I will leave you with an exercise where you can answer these questions about your own research project. Okay, let's start with the opening. What is the larger problem I'm addressing? In my case, it's how to model large, multidimensional quantum networks. And why am I addressing this problem? Well, there are a couple of reasons. Some of them are that quantum networks will be needed for quantum communication tasks, such as quantum cryptography and connecting quantum computers. Realistic networks are going to be large, and to design them, it'll be good if we have good ways to model them, which we don't presently have. Now let's look at the funnel. What do we need to understand about the situation to follow the story? Well, we need to understand that the best way to send quantum information is with quantum light, that waveguides can be used to send light. To make a network, you also need nodes. Quantum networks should have quantum systems at the nodes. And the simplest quantum system is a two-level system, otherwise known as a qubit. Now let's move on to the challenge. What specific questions do I propose to answer? Well, again, there's a couple. The first is, can we extend an existing theory of qubits inside 1D waveguides interacting with a single photon to D-dimensional systems? And if so, under which assumptions and what features can we model? Now we finally get to the action. What did we do to address the challenge? Well, we proposed a conjecture relating 1D waveguides to D-dimensional waveguides. We tested the conjecture in a variety of settings. And we used the theory to model superradiance in large multidimensional systems. And what were our findings? Well, we found that the conjecture holds in all settings tested. We found how superradiance scales with the dimension D. And we found that superradiance is more fragile in high dimensions. And finally, we also discovered a new effect of superradiance segregation in dimensions larger than one. Okay, and now we can move on to the resolution. So we want to answer the question, how has the larger problem from the opening changed as a result of our work? Well, we now have a method for modeling a specific type of multidimensional quantum network composed of intersecting waveguides. And this should be useful for designing complex quantum networks. Okay, so now you've seen an example of how one would answer the specific questions for each of the OCAR elements. And now it's your turn to do the same for your research projects. So just to remind you, the questions related to the opening, funnel, challenge, action, and resolution are as follows. And again, it's a good time for you to pause the video while you work on this exercise. Try not to spend more than 15 minutes on it. So hopefully you've had a chance to go through the exercise, and now you'll have a rough idea of the kinds of things you're going to discuss in each of the sections. But you might be thinking that, well, I don't usually see papers with headings such as opening, challenge, action, resolutions. Most of the papers we see have sections such as introduction, methods, results, and discussion, or some variation of that theme. So what we'd like to do now is map the elements from OCAR to the section headings in a research paper, collectively known as IMRAD. This is pretty trivial to do. All we do is identify the OCAR elements and then map them as follows. Now all I've done is change the delineation between the sections. So now we have a structure and we already answered each of these questions. Now it's just a matter of fleshing these out. And we'll look at how to do that in the next videos. In the meantime, let's just do one more exercise. I'd like you to map your OCAR elements to the IMRAD section headings. And in your document, make sure you include not just the section headings and the questions, but also your own personal answers to the questions that you did in the previous exercise. In upcoming videos, you're going to build on this document as you continue writing your paper or thesis. So now is a good time to pause this video for 2 minutes as you do this exercise. Okay, well, I hope you've had a chance to do the second exercise. And let's just do a quick summary of what we learned today. Each of the OCAR elements that we've seen should answer some particular questions. And writing down the answers to these questions in a document helps overcoming writer's block, and it creates text that can be expanded later. And finally, papers don't have OCAR headings, so we should map OCAR to IMRAD. In the next video, we will focus on writing the introduction by fleshing out the answers to the questions we looked at in this video. See you next time!